these images from the security cameras. Now, this is the attempted liquor store robber.
Very blurry.
I can't really see it.
You guys might want to physically zoom in yourself, so zoom in. Zoom times two. Times three. Yeah, that should do it. I have had Parker analyse the thermal imaging footage and get a sketch artist to create a composite of what the creature might look like.
Here you go, Sarge.
Thank you, Parker. Just so you know, guys, Parker here has gone completely invisible. Are you out of uniform, Parker?
No, Sarge.
Are you naked?
Yes, Sarge. I took it off because I was like, I wonder if the invisibility has infected my entire body. Plus, it's really warm in here, and I just thought, you know, being invisible, no one will know. It's actually quite liberating.
So. I don't care. Go get your uniform back on.
Can't find it. It's invisible.
It's unacceptable, Parker. Dismissed.
Oh, yeah. Don't touch my face. Out.
Shut the door, please. Thank you. Right. I know you're still in here, Parker. I can hear you breathing.
Sorry, Sarge.
Go. Now, please.
Yes, sir.
I've handed these out to all the available officers on duty. Told them if they feel anything like this, they're to report it in.
I've seen this before.
Have you really?
Well, now that maybe not, actually.
I was going to say, because if you'd seen that, you would have mentioned it to me.
It looks familiar, okay, to some extent.
That looks familiar.
Yes, just the image.
But to be honest, guys, I don't fancy our chances of finding this creature. We've failed. Yeah. I think perhaps for the first time ever.
No, I take offence at that. We've failed heaps. Heaps and heaps.
I mean, but there's been some pretty tough cases that haven't worked, panned out, you know? I mean, despite our best efforts.
We've got a long list of failures.
They're not, it's just a list, but it is a list.
Case in point, another failure.
Sounds like excuses. Have you at least filed a victim's report from the residents at the house?
No.
We got distracted by the invisible thing and then things got out of hand, eh? And it's been a hard night.
Hard.
Can you please get out there and get that report done, bring it back to me?
Yes.
Also, keep an eye out for that creature there.
The invisible one?
Yeah, as much as you can. Probably won't see it.
Does it look like that?
Or
like that?
Like that.
That's probably what we're looking for, though.
Yeah, it's probably more accurate, right? Yeah.
Okay.
So we should still take that?
Keep an eye out for that.
Just go.
Yep.
Just go. Thank you. Okay, take a look at this. This is a still image of Joe Blake's from his interview. Here, he looks like he's in his 40s, hair going grey.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Here, he looks like he's in his 20s. Yeah? Side by side.
Yeah, but I mean, he can make himself look like anything.
Yes, but only what you fear. Remember when we had him in custody and he kept asking for something to eat? I don't think he was hungry for food. I think what we're dealing with here is possibly superhuman metamorph who feeds on fear by turning into what scares you the most. And that's not all. I cross-referenced hospital files with his customer records, and it turns out that several of his patrons suffered heart failure from fatal amounts of adrenaline in their bodies. Literally scared to death.
That literally just scared me to death.
Do you know what the word literally means?
I actually don't. I've been peppering it into my conversations to make myself sound more elegant.
Noak, don't ever misuse the word literally, not on my watch.
Easy.
All right, I want you two to find this thing before it terrifies the entire city.
Oh, except for me.
Manok, it's night time.
I think he thinks they make him look a little bit cool.
I don't think they make me look cool.
All right.
Oh! Is that you, Parker? Here. In 2001, almost 20 years to the day, six people travelling to the Wellington Sevens rugby game were killed in the car accident. As you may recall, the Wellington Sevens involved attendees wearing colourful and fun group-themed costumes, mainly big men in little dresses. The people that died that day, however, were all dressed in stripy tops, beanies and glasses, just like the two guys that you picked up, and the kidnapper.
They're dressed like Wally from my favourite book, Where's Wally?
Don't believe I'm familiar with that particular literature, Where is Wally?
Oh, that's a type of literature where the reader is tasked with finding a character called Wally. Here's the reason why I got into policing.
Why, because you always found him?
No, I never found him.
You never found him?
I'm still working on the case. I'm actually working on a hunch that he doesn't actually exist in the book at all.
Interesting. I've had Parker track down the costume, and it's actually called
Lost Traveller, Glasses Man.
That's Wally.
Well, I think perhaps for legal reasons, they've chosen to call the costume Lost Traveller, Glasses Man.
Wally.
Well, I'd prefer if you called it Lost Traveller, Glasses Man, legal reasons.
Okay, look, how did the Lost Traveller, Glasses Men die?
Good question. Their van crashed into another vehicle containing people dressed as sexy crayons. It then flew off an off-ramp into the side of the building. Fortunately, the sexy crayons escaped unharmed.
Slight digression here, Sarge, but can crayons be sexy?
Yes, they can be. They sure can be. Yes, they can.
Sarge,
That's not what is important here. There is a spirit at loose trying to drag the living into the realm of the dead. So I want the two of you to get out there
look
and...
Look for this, Wally.
The lost traveller glasses man.
Thank you.
Is this where you wanted to meet?
Obviously. So, let me get this straight. Not only did you not find the missing persons, not find the suspect, you also managed to ruin your uniforms.
And the car.
Yeah, but it could have been worse.
How?
We could have ruined the car worse.
Let's keep this brief. You both smell horrible. Can you give me a description of what the assailant looked like?
Description's tough.
Yeah, I mean, I'd start with blobby.
I'd throw in gelatinous.
Blobby.
Really good.
Yeah, I saw some arms and legs in there.
Yeah, there was also a couple of human faces.
I remember a face.
Yeah, there was, and then face. Making that sort of that muffled noise. It was almost like there was like a membrane or something.
Like the face was right. Can I use your lunchbox for a sec? Yeah.
Hell.
Didn't know. No, like this.
That's good.
That actually makes me think that you were doing it.
It wasn't me. I was in the car, but I could hear that noise.
It does sound a little bit like a cat.
No, a cat's more like this.
Yeah, I often make that mistake though. Sometimes I think the neighbours are calling help, but really it's my cat calling meow.
You don't have a cat?
Well, not anymore.
Right, hello. Stay absolutely still. Don't move.
What? What is it?
Yep, no.
Is it on me?
Yep.
It's on me, isn't it?
Yep.
I can feel it on my face.
I'm gonna punch
it off my face.
Don't punch it. Don't. Come here. Come. I'm over here.
Get it off.
There you go. Ugh. That's suspicious. Right. Well, I'm gonna get this to the lab. In the meanwhile, there have been reports of a horrible smell coming from the Waterloo area. To be honest, I did initially ignore the calls. I thought it was more of a council issue, but then they started to report missing pets.
Should you really be ignoring calls, Sarge?
Don't question me.